day, aqua friends. I have an underpainting here that I did a few years ago that I wanted to share with you today. I am painting these rocks, and they're fun because they have a lot of texture, shadows, and patterns. And this tutorial is basically how to develop these rocks. So as an underpainting for the rocks, I made them blue. They are really dark towards the end, but this was my underpainting. So the blues that I used are blues that are on the cool side. So they really pull towards that purple, pulling out the really pretty purples in this sunset. The pink part that I used is quinacridone scarlet along with some ochre right at the horizon line where it's really pink. I added a little bit of ochre there. And the mountains in the background are just a mixture of some browns in the sap green as an underpainting. There's lots of reflections on these rocks, and the dark parts are very, very dark. And so I used indigo and neutral tint for the rocks. So I developed the rocks by using layers of paint as well as scraping in designs and marks with a palette brush, and saran wrap also makes angular textures that works really well with rocks. So I am doing the rocks wet on dry watercolor technique to get those sharp edges, and just adding some texture. The paper that I'm using is Arches 140 pound cold press. So I'm alternating between a round 8 and a smaller size 2 for a detail brush for the lines on the rock. So the rocks have a lot of reflection of the pink sunset, and so I'm trying to get those colors in on the rocks as well. Thank you. So as these areas dry, I'm going back over and adding more detail, more shadows, and more crevices in these rocks. There are a lot of rocks on this rocky shoreline, and I have to sort of group them together and not get lost too much into the detail and kind of look at these shapes as clusters. And I'm just trying to sketch out these large boulders of this rocky shoreline to get the biggest mass of rocks. So right now I'm just drawing in the shapes that I see over top of the blue that I've already laid down as a base coat for these rocks. Kind of see that taking shape now. And those bluer areas around the rocks are kind of like the shadows. The background mountains are darker, so I'm adding in my next layer on those using neutral tint. That really makes the sunset pop more with everything getting darker here. Thank you. I wet my brush and I'm still letting the green show through, but I've darkened up that area a lot. I'm getting my horizon line nice and straight. Okay, and turning it around to work on that other mountain. With a very wet brush, I'm putting in those shadows around the rocks. Getting everything as dark as it needs to be is really making the whole colors of the purples and pinks really pop against the dark. So I'm wetting down some areas and just to get the overall textural effect of everything, I'm putting a wet glaze over all these rocks. And I'm taking my knife and scraping some lines into it, just to get a more textured, rock-looking effects. Might as well throw some plastic wrap for some good use out of there too.